Earlier, the 7th Congress of the party was held in 2002. Now the Central Committee gave us the honor again of holding the 22nd Congress of this party in this city, in the newly formed state of Telangana. As all you know, the heroic Telangana armed struggle and the sacrifices made by the people under the leadership of the Communist Party to overthrow the feudal Nizam rule. This great struggle brought the agrarian question onto the central stage of independent India's politics. Several decades have passed and many changes have occurred in agrarian relations, but the land question still remains relevant. Without resolving this problem satisfactorily, India can't become a truly modern society. In this regard, the great Telangana armed struggle still inspires us throughout the country to undertake militant struggles against the feudal or semi-feudal or modern-day capitalist agrarian classes. Let me recall another important struggle that took place in 2000 against the structural adjustment programs implemented under the guidance of the World Bank in the United Andhra Pradesh. On August 28th, April of 2002, three youngsters were killed in Hyderabad in the brutal police firing unleashed by the then TDP government. This militant struggle put a spoke in the relentless wheels of structural adjustment policies pursued by the governments. The present BJP central government led by Modi, which was selected by the corporate class as the best bet to carry on the neoliberal reforms, is trying to bulldoze all opposition to these reforms. As was never before, the time has come now to mount an unrelenting onslaught on the neoliberal policies by all classes and sections. Only uncompromising, sustained struggle against neoliberalism can create an anti-communal, anti-capitalist, anti-imperialist common sense among the people, which will recreate an environment conducive for the spread of ideas of socialism. In order to weaken the unity of the common people and the struggle against neoliberal reforms and delete the progressive forces from the people, Hindutva communal forces and the BJP central government under Modi, in the service of the exploiting classes, playing on the people's anxieties and insecurities generated by the market forces, and unbridled consumerism, are trying to communalize every aspect of social life through aggressive pursuance of the communal agenda. In these circumstances, mere work in electoral arena can't wipe out the communalism from social life. Only confronting communalism at all levels of civil society and social life can create ground for the growth of progressive, democratic, rationalistic and inclusive culture. In the present conditions, to forge an unbreakable link with the masses, there is no need to overemphasize the importance of the work in the fields of ideology and culture and social service. As you all know, communists were in the forefront of intellectual and cultural and social reform movements among Telugu-speaking people from the beginning. Mobilization, against caste oppression, patriarchy, and for communal harmony were used to be closely integrated to the class struggles in the past. This legacy is one of the important resources that is helping now to counter the communal forces in Telugu states. As you know, there are so many factors that are inhibiting the growth of BJP in Telugu-speaking states. I am not going into all those things. One thing I want to emphasize is the legacy inherited by the communist and progressive people from the movements of the parties is giving strength and resource to us so that we can mobilize the people against this menace of communism. Let me share with you a brief account of the work done by Vijnana Kendram, with which we are associated within Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Our Sundaraya Vijnana Kendram, which was established in Hyderabad in 1988 in memory of great communist and legendary leader of Telangana people's armed struggle, Comrade B.V. Sundaraya, has become a center of progressive cultural and social service activities. Many other similar institutions came up in many parts of Telangana and Andhra. Our party units in both Telangana and Andhra are trying to scale up this work to expand to all parts of these states. At the present juncture, struggle for social justice assumes greater urgency and importance. As BJP and Sangh Parivar's feudal reactionary intra-communal elements escalate their ideological, physical attacks, violence on socially oppressed sections, Dalits, artisans, tribals, women, minorities, as the neoliberal policies suddenly hit the weaker sections of the society hard, fight for their rights and social justice assumes greater importance in the present conditions. Recognizing this importance in our fight against communalism in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, we have been consistently taking up the issues of social justice. For the past 2.5 decades, as a culmination of these efforts for social justice, the CPIM Telangana committee successfully organized Mahajana Padayatra for 154 days, covering 4,200 kilometers, touching 1,520 habitations, ending in a mammoth rally in Hyderabad. The state secretary and 8 other important cadres undertook this marathon Mahajana Padayatra. It is on the basis of fight for social justice and comprehensive development of the state with a comprehensive alternative program this program has taken place. And we promise here to take forward this fight for social justice so that not only giving justice to the oppressed sections is an important weapon in our fight against communal forces. Now what is happening all over India we know, and how Dalits are being persecuted and attacked by the communal forces, how women are being raped and tortured in many parts of the country. So gender justice and social justice are two of the important planks in our fight against communalism. In our humble way, we are taking forward this struggle in Telangana and Andhra. Struggle for the protection of democracy and democratic rights is also an important part of our fight for alternative politics, for mobilizing forces, for building left and democratic front. Our advanced outposts in West Bengal, Tripura and Kerala targeted by communal and reactionary forces in order to eliminate left forces from the country's political arena. I take this opportunity to salute all those fighting cadre and people in these advanced outposts of left movement and appeal to all democratic and progressive forces in Telangana to stand in solidarity with them. Let's salute to all those martyrs and comrades who are fighting for this. I would like the opportunity of this occasion to thank all those democratic and progressive organizations, personalities who are associating with us, helping and encouraging us in various ways in our endeavors in both states of Telangana and Andhra. And many of those progressive and intellectuals, many of those activists and leaders who are working on issues of social justice and progressive ideas, they are here, and we again, I take this opportunity to thank them, and we want them to be with us in our fight. We always will be with them in their fight against the social oppression and these things. And I also thank the people of Hyderabad and Telangana who in the most difficult circumstances supported us to continue our struggle against exploitation and oppression. I thank all those who directly and indirectly helped us in organizing this 22nd Congress of CPIM in Hyderabad in a befitting way. Dear delegates and comrades and observers, if there are any shortcomings from our side, please bear with us and bring to our notice so that we can rectify them, so that we can be a good host to you. Comrades and friends, in the end I want to say, struggle is the essence of the life. Class struggle is the driving force of history. As long as communists continue the struggle, nothing on earth can anguish them. Thank you very much.